Hi there, this is Tony from pianotone.ca, and this video is to let you know about a really cool new feature that has been added to SongBook Pro. SongBook Pro is a really awesome app that I use to manage my chord chart music library. The new feature is the ability to start a copy of a song or a backing track playing from within SongBook Pro that you can play along with as the chords or music scrolls by you. So if you're not familiar with SongBook Pro, you're going to want to watch my full review first. There's a link below in the description, which will show you what SongBook Pro is and how it works. Then once you watch that, then you can come back to this one. But if you're already familiar with SongBook Pro and just want to see how this new feature works, then let's check it out. So I make heavy use of backing tracks when I practice my piano. Sometimes I'll make them using an app called iReal Pro, and other times I buy them from an app called Jamzone. I do have a full review on Jamzone, there's a link to that below. I haven't actually reviewed iReal Pro yet, but there are tons of great videos out there on how to use iReal Pro, so just search that if you're interested. Now, once I have my backing tracks created, I would always store them in the Files app on my iPad in the Files folder. Now, when I want to play along with one of these, I would switch over to SongBook Pro and get the chord chart ready. So I'm going to go load up the chord chart for Let It Be. Then I would switch back to the Files app, get my backing track ready to go. Then I would click play on the backing track to start it playing. And then I would switch back over to SongBook Pro and start the chord chart scrolling. So not the end of the world, but it is a little bit on the clunky side, especially if you're wanting to stop and start and restart and that type of thing, or pause or whatever. So I noticed my iPad was getting updated and that SongBook Pro was being updated, I thought I'd go check it out, and lo and behold, noticed a new play button in the bottom right. And that's where you get access to this cool new feature. So for this example, I'm going to load the chord chart for Piano Man. Don't actually have a backing track made for this yet. I'm just starting to learn this song, but I do want to have something to play along with. So the first time that you click on the play button, if you haven't set up anything for the song yet, it's going to prompt you for the source that you want to use. So the first one I'll talk about is actually the least interesting, which is the pad backing tracks. What this is going to do is just play a very generic kind of swirly pad background that will be based on the key signature of the song. So you can see that I've got the song key set to C. So it's basically going to play like a C major chord or a C and a fifth or something in the key of C. Just as a swirly general background, it's not going to change chords, it's not going to follow me or anything. So it's just kind of a very plain background. So while that might be better than nothing, it's the other two options that are actually the really cool ones. So to switch my source, I'm actually going to long press the play button. So hold my finger down on it until this little menu comes up. To get rid of the pad backing track, I can either click trash or I can just click the pencil, and then that's just going to ask me to specify a new source. Okay, so to set this up for the Spotify option, you do need to have the Spotify app installed on your device, and you do need an account. I have the Spotify app installed on my iPad, and I actually have a free account, and there is an issue with the free account that I'll talk to you about in a minute. Now, when I click on the Spotify choice, it's going to start the Spotify app, and then I'm going to see a list of options for Piano Man by Billy Joel from Spotify, and it's actually going to start playing the top one in the list. I'm actually going to choose the top one in the list because that's the one that I want. And then it's going to return me back to SongBook Pro. But then what I need to do actually, and this is a bit of a bug between how these two apps are interacting with each other, is I'm going to need to click save in SongBook Pro to save this choice of the track that I want from Spotify. Then I need to close SongBook Pro, and I need to close Spotify, and then reopen SongBook Pro. Because if I don't do that, the song is going to keep playing and keep playing and keep playing. You won't be able to pause it. You won't be able to stop it or anything. But I found if you actually just close all of the apps up after you set it up and saved it, then it works fine once you reopen them. So if you watch all of this, you'll see what I mean. Okay, so now that I've done all of that and saved it, when I click play again, then the song's, it's gonna load up Spotify again and the song will start to play. Except now you're gonna see that I'm gonna be able to play and pause it and it will behave nice and normal for me. So you can see I can pause it and then restart. So a little kind of flaky there. Maybe that is something that can be cleaned up in a future update. But as long as you know that you need to do all of that, works fine. Now, the other issue with the fact that I'm using a free account, and this kind of caught me off guard. I was playing, practicing along with Piano Man, played it 3 or 4 times in a row. Then all of a sudden this ad came on and it caught me off guard, but there's the reason I'm hearing an ad is because I'm not using the paid version of Spotify. I'm using a free account. So as long as you know that that can happen and won't catch you too off guard, but just something to be aware of. So now to the backing track option. For this one, I'm gonna switch over to Let It Be, which I do have a backing track for. So now when I click on play, I'm gonna be choosing the device option instead. Now this device option has a requirement. The track needs to be in your device's default music app. So on my iPad, it needs to be in my iTunes library. I'm assuming it would there would be a similar requirement on Android, but I don't have an Android device, so I can't really help out with that. Now I was hoping when I first tried the device option that I'd just be able to browse to my Files app a folder where all my tracks are, but no such luck. You can see when I click device that it's going to take me to my music library. Now I can understand that because as an ex-developer myself, I can imagine that it's probably much easier for the SongBook Pro developers to connect to the device's default music app than it is to try and remember a folder in the files section. So in order for me to get my backing tracks into my iTunes library, I had to copy them to my PC, add them to my iTunes library on my PC, and while I was there, I actually went into each one of them and went into the track info and specified that they were from an album called Backing Tracks. You'll see why in a minute. It just makes it a little cleaner once they come back to the iPad. Then I connected my iPad to my computer and then resynced my iPad, so all of those backing tracks now got copied over, and then they land in my library on my iPad. Kind of convoluted, but once I got the hang of it, it's really not that big of a deal. I'm not going to demo all of that here because it would take forever. If you don't know how to sync music from iTunes to your iPad, then please just search for videos and instructions on how to do that. So if I go into Artists and I choose this piano tone guy, actually, hey, you're going to see my first original song that I wrote on piano called Walk With You, which is now available on Spotify and on Apple Music. I'll also link to a video that I made for that below. So a little plug for myself there. But anyways, back to SongBook Pro. You can see I've got this backing tracks selection, and that's because when I had these in iTunes on my computer, I specified that they were all belong to a backing tracks album, so that way they land in one spot here. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the backing track for Let It Be. Then I don't want to click play here. If I click play once, it's not going to play. If I click play twice, it will, but it won't save. So just click the save button. Now that I've done that, everything's perfect. You're good to go, and it will remember that, and you'll be able to load the backing track up and then start it scrolling right from in SongBook Pro, which is way nicer than it was before when you had to bounce back and forth between the Files app and SongBook Pro. Okay, so just to kind of recap everything, if you are using Spotify, you do need to have a Spotify account and you have to have the app installed on your device. I am using the free Spotify account and it does work, other than that occasional ad feature. And to use the device option, your music files must be registered within your device's default music app. So in the case of an iPad, you need to have the tracks added to your iTunes, and then you have to sync your iPad to move those tracks over. But once that's done, you're good to go. One other thing I should note is how this works if you are using SongBook Pro on multiple devices. For example, I use it mostly on my iPad, but I do also occasionally use it on my iPhone. Now, if you've watched my main review, you'll know that you can set up SongBook Pro to sync your data between your devices. What I've noticed when doing this is that any of the songs that I have set up to use songs on the device, so my iTunes songs or backing tracks that are registered within my music app, those work fine on the phone or on the iPad after having synced them up. I don't have to manually set them up on both devices. But for the Spotify or just the plain pad choices, those choices don't seem to sync. Possibly something that could be addressed in a future update. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've been using SongBook Pro and like to play along with backing tracks, then you're gonna love this feature, I know I do. And if you haven't tried SongBook Pro, I highly recommend checking it out. It's really not very expensive and it's super useful. And once again, I have a link to my full review to SongBook Pro below. And if you have Spotify or Apple Music, check out my first original song on piano. It's called Walk With You. If you search Walk With You piano tone, you'll find it. I'm super excited to have that out there. So I just thought I'd mention that. Thanks for checking this out and have an awesome day.